Welcome, welcome, welcome to another When Christians Speak Talk Radio. Hallelujah. Glory to God. A voice crying out in today's wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. This is your host today, Reverend Pat Randall. Just call me Reverend Pat. And this is Declaring the Finished Work Hour. And so I'm excited about today. And I praise God for this day. This is the day that He has made. And He made it for us. So we're going to choose to rejoice. We're going to choose to be glad in it. I'm going to remind you what He says about His plans that He has for you. Over in Jeremiah 29:11, He says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." Glory to God. I'm going to start off the broadcast. We're going to pray, and then we're going to get into what the Lord has for us today. I'll make a few announcements. Glory to God. Let you know what's coming up on the broadcast. And I'm excited about today's broadcast. I'm excited about what the Spirit of the Lord is speaking in this hour. So let's go into the throne room. Praise God. Father, we thank You for this day. We thank You that it is the day that You have made for us. We thank You this morning for waking us up. We thank You for the breath that You give us, which is our life. We thank You that You are a faithful Father, that You never leave us. You never forsake us. You are ever present with us. In fact, You have secured it through Your Son, Jesus Christ, by sending Him into the earth. The Word made flesh dwelt among us and gave up His life for us so that we would be restored into right relationship with You, that today we can stand before You confidently and boldly because of His finished work. So we thank You for loving us so much, for loving us that You would send Him into this world while we were still enemies of You. But You so loved us that You gave us Your Son, Jesus. So we thank You. We thank You. We thank You that no matter what we may be facing in this day, that You have made us more than conquerors. You have informed us ahead of time that there are going to be trials and tribulations, but we can be of good cheer, for You have rendered this world powerless to do harm against us. You have made a show of our real enemy, who is the devil, and You have rendered him powerless when it comes to Your children. You have restored dominion and authority in the earth back to man. And we want to thank You. We don't want to take for granted the price that our Lord and Savior paid so that we may have this inheritance. We thank You, Lord Jesus. We thank You for coming and humbling Yourself. Even though You are yet God, You humbled Yourself. You made of Yourself no reputation. You allowed yourself to be abused in situations, to be disrespected, to be spit upon, to be beaten and bruised for our iniquity and our in trespasses. You took our sins upon you, and they were condemned and punished in your body upon the cross, that by your stripes we would be healed, that by your blood that was shed for us, that we would be restored to right standing with God. That whosoever believes and confesses in their heart that you are Lord and that you came for the forgiveness of sin and receive you, we are cleansed of all unrighteousness. We praise you and we thank you. We thank you for this glorious inheritance. We thank you for loving us. You said it was a joy that was set before you, that you would endure the cross. Oh, greater love hath no man than this. So we praise you. We give this broadcast hour to you today. Holy Spirit, come in, have your way through the airways. We know that our enemy who comes against us, he is the prince of this world. But we thank you, Lord God, that you have rendered him powerless over your children. So during this hour, I take full authority and dominion through the power of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, just move and speak through me. I thank you for the technological aspect of this broadcast, that you keep these airways clear, that you allow these devices to work properly. I thank you that the word of the Lord will go forth unhindered in the name of Christ Jesus. So we give thanks, and it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For he is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, you know, we're a young ministry. We're relatively young. We just celebrated an anniversary actually in February of this year, and so it is actually 2 years that we have been on the air. And so, you know, when you're starting a young ministry, you know, when you start out, you're basically those who have been called alongside, and I'm one of the ones have been called alongside of Reverend Ray, who actually founded this talk radio broadcast. And praise God for that, that he submitted to the leading of the Holy Spirit, and he reached into his own pocket and financed this broadcast. Praise God. And I've been called alongside of my brother, who I love, to co-labor in this vineyard. And I thank God. I thank God. So a lot of the things that happen on this broadcast, the announcements, these recordings and the music, and I mean, all of this is just done by a couple of people. And so I'm doing all of this to actually, it's kind of like a disclaimer, because I have a broadcast, I mean, not a broadcast, but in a commercial that I recorded, and I've been having problems with the recording, and I'm praying that it will work today. If not, I'm going to have to re-record this thing, which I do. I really don't want to, because there are some other things that I need to be recording. But praise the Lord, we shall see. I'm going to play this this first commercial. If it doesn't work, I'll come back and deliver it live. But praise God. Let's see what happens.
Broadcasting out of the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. Today's voice crying out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. When Christians Speak is dedicated to lifting up the name of Christ Jesus and spreading the good news. We invite you to join us every Tuesday at 7 p.m. for his Abounding Grace show with Minister Vanester Williams. Every Thursday, live at 12 noon, join Reverend Pat Randall for Declaring the Finished Work. Reverend Ray and friends are here on Friday night at 7 p.m. with the Joy of the Lord on Friday Night Joy. Sundays at 7 p.m., join Sister Valerie Miller and co-host Reverend Gray on Stronger Together. For more information, go to our website, www.whenchristianspeak.com. That's www.whenchristianspeak.com.
Well, praise God, that is not bad. It could be better, but it is so much better than it was last week. The sound is a lot better. So praise God. I thank God for that. And also, I want to add to that, because tomorrow night, on Friday Night Joy, Reverend Ray has a very special guest coming on with him, Sister Lakeisha Williams, and she is the founder of Born Overcomers, Inc. And in fact, maybe a few months ago, they recently had their first Overcomers event. Praise God, in this Washington, D.C. metropolitan area, which is where the broadcast comes out of the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. And so she is the founder, as I said, of Born Overcomers, Inc. She also owns a consulting firm, and she owns another business, quite an entrepreneur, Lakeisha L. Williams Enterprises, LLC. So that tomorrow's broadcast will be an exciting Friday Night Joy broadcast. So make sure you join Reverend Ray and Sister Lakeisha tomorrow night at 7 p.m. That's Eastern Standard Time, and 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. Praise God. Now, this last Saturday, if you missed the broadcast last Saturday, a prophetic win, oh my goodness, we had Prophet Tori Knox on the air with us Saturday evening, and praise God, she had a word from God. And so I am going to post that out. I'm going to post that link to that particular podcast out on Facebook today, because she'll be coming back with us again in April. In fact, it's April the 4th. She'll be back that particular Saturday at 7 in the evening. But I think before she comes back, you need to make sure you listen to this past Saturday's Prophetic Wind broadcast. Praise God. You know, the Spirit of the Lord is moving in this season in such a way. for those of you who are paying attention in the spirit, you know that he is moving and pouring out himself in a greater measure in this season. And it's for the purpose, of himself being glorified in the earth. The enemy may be trying to distract us and to terrorize the world, because we as the body of Christ refuse to be terrorized by his tactics, because we know they are smoke and mirrors. They are temporary things. They're temporary storms that he starts up. But glory to God, the power of God is greater than any weapon that he could forge. Glory to God. And so what God is doing in this season is something to catch hold of. Let it stir you up. Let it create an excitement and a fire inside of you, so that you can step into this greater glory that he is releasing into the earth during this time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Also, next Thursday, I have my a very special guest joining me again. A few months ago, she was with me on Declaring the Finished Work, but she'll be back here next Thursday, which is the 19th, Apostle Shirley Jones, and she's also the pastor of Rehoboth Family Life Center in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. And when she came on, I believe it was at the very top of the year, yes, she gave a message. It was a prophetic word, because she spoke of what God was doing in 2015. Glory to God. So I'm excited about her coming back and just hearing what God has been speaking since the last time she was on the broadcast. So make sure that you're with us next Thursday. Glory to God. Also, to listen by phone, you can call in by 646-478-0660. That number is 646-478-0660. Also, the chat room is now open. So if you want to join me out there in the chat room, praise God, it is available. Also, the song that we opened with today, I Say Yes, that was sang by Andrea Rose, praise God. So just want to recognize Andrea Rose and that lovely voice and just her ministry gift. And we thank God for that. We thank God for all of the ministry gifts. We thank God for the plan for the body of Christ, that we were part of the manifold wisdom of God. Glory to God. This whole redemption process, because this is not just the redemption of man. This is redemption of the earth, redemption of the heavens. I mean, it is a new heaven and a new earth that we are moving towards. And, you know, when I began the broadcast at the top of the year, I began with the scripture out of Isaiah 9, where it speaks of his government and his peace, the increase of his government and peace shall know no end. And so it is steadily increasing, and we are part of that plan, because we have been entrusted with the ministry of reconciliation. That's a powerful thing. And that God himself would entrust us. God reconciled us to himself in Jesus Christ. So we who now know him, glory to God, we have been given, glory to God, the power to reconcile man through Jesus Christ, because the Spirit of Christ lives on the inside of us. The kingdom of God is not here and it's not there. It is in us, and he is seeking to expand it within us to the point that it moves outside of us, and everywhere we go, we affect change and we infect others. Glory. That's magnificent. It is absolutely magnificent when you think of that. So I'm going to be back in a moment, and I'm going to start the teaching to, I don't call it a teaching because I'm an exhorter. And yeah, I do teach during my exhortations, but basically I am an exhorter because I come to encourage, I come to admonish, to make the body strong, to speak life into the body, to make decrees and declarations over the body that the fullness of what God has made available will manifest itself in you. In you, praise God. So today, I've been given out of Ephesians 5, verse 14, this title, Awake Thou That Sleepest. So I'm going to be back in a moment to start this most exciting journey and see how far I get today, because I am always amazed how quickly, when we're having fun in the Lord, I mean, sometimes you lose sense of time and you don't realize how much time has gone forth. But that, you know, that's a good thing, to be able to be so caught up in his presence that you lose sense of time. In his presence, there is fullness of joy. In his presence, there is peace. In his presence, there is healing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is the church.
Sometimes you have to speak victory during
Hey, hallelujah. I'm encouraged. I'm encouraged. I love that line where that was Encourage Yourself by Donald Lawrence. But I love that statement where that lyric where she says, when I minister to you, I minister to myself. And I think that's one of the reasons I also find such joy in doing the broadcast, because as the Holy Spirit is ministering through me, I'm also being ministered to. I'm also being fed. I'm also hearing the Word of God. I'm also exposing myself to that transformative power of God. And once I finish the broadcast, I am telling you, there is so much peace and so much joy and so much healing that has taken place. Glory, glory to God. I just want to just stop for a moment right here and just praise God. Oh, I think of all that I have, my life, and all the things, the seasons of my life, and I can see the faithfulness of God in all these things, and how He has never left me, even when I did not know Him, even when I was unlovely. He loved me. He never gave up on me, and I thank Him. I thank Him that today that I have a greater revelation because of Him in my life and working in my life, that I have a greater revelation of His love for me. I have a greater revelation of what it means to be saved by grace, and that it's not by works, lest any man should boast. What that means. I want to thank Him. I want to thank Him that where His Spirit is, that there is liberty. I want to thank my Lord and Savior for coming to set the captive free. Every day, more of the things that have bound my life are dissipating, are dropping off, losing their power over my life. And it's not because of anything that I've done, but it is because of the power of God at work in my life. It is by faith that we were saved, and it's by faith that we live out this life in Him. There is nothing that do that would make Him more effective in my life other than believing and trusting in Him and yielding to His movement in my life. And I can only yield myself and trust Him by the assurance that His love for me is perfect. The scripture tells us that perfect love drives out all fear. For fear torments. Fear is a tormenting spirit. And in Peter, it tells us that, you know, God did not give us a spirit of fear, but He gave us a spirit of power, a spirit of love, and a sound mind. Praise God. Fear is of the devil. It is not of God. Fear is of the devil. So I just want to praise you, Lord, and acknowledge you today in my life, and thank you for all that you have done and continue to do. Glory to God. I thank you that it is your goodness that continuously leads me into repentance. It causes me to change the way I think. It gives me the ability to pull away from the things of this world that have tugged at my heart or tugged at my attention, to know that all things are in you. So praise your holy name, Father. Praise your holy name, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thank you for that Godhead residing on the inside of me. Glory to God. He is so worthy. He is so worthy, people of God. He is so worthy to be praised. Maintain a grateful heart. Acknowledge even the smallest things that he does for you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, let me get to my exhortation, if I can. I'm just so grateful. I'm so thankful. In the prayer group last night when we were praying, that's we didn't ask God for anything. We just thanked him and praised him and extolled his name. We magnified the Lord last night because he is surely he is worthy. Surely he is worthy. Do not allow the enemy to deceive you and to trick you out of the fullness of this joy, because it is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. As I was saying earlier, the Awake Thou That Sleepest, this title came out of Ephesians 5:14. So I am going to read a bit of that scripture to you. I love reading the Word of God. The Word of God, and just keep in mind that when you're reading it, that there is life in it. And if you are receiving death from something that you are reading, if it is condemning you and causing you to pull back from God, then the Spirit of God is not present, because the Spirit gives life, not death. The Spirit gives life, and the letter of the word kills. So you have to have the Spirit of God to give life to this written word. That is where the power is. That is where the healing is. It's in his Spirit. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So if you have your Bibles, if not, you know, if you have your laptops, your computers, your you know, all your Android devices and your Apple devices, go online, open up a Bible app. And let's go to Ephesians chapter 5, and I'm going to start in verse 14. And even though I'm not going to be speaking about all of these things that are in these verses from 14 to 21, I'm going to read them anyway because they're good verses. Verse 14, wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. That's where our light comes from, Christ. Christ in me. See then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. You know, the scripture says, be wise as a serpent, yet gentle as a dove. Verse 16, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. For be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit. I'm going to back up to verse 17, where it says, wherefore be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. Being able to understand what the will of the Lord is requires an intimacy with your Lord and Savior. It requires an intimacy even with the Holy Spirit, who is here to teach and to unveil our Savior to us. He will speak to us only those things which he hears from our Lord. And the things that he speaks to us that comes from our Lord is the will of the Lord. So in order to know the will of the Lord, you've got to walk by the Spirit. Glory to God. Let's go to 18. And be not drunk with wine, amen, because it affects your mind. It's hard to renew your mind when it's drunk, wherein in excess, but be filled with the Spirit. That's what you want to be filled. If you're going to be drunk off anything, be drunk off his Spirit. Glory to God. Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Glory to God. Singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Glory to God. Singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Music is wonderful. It has such healing properties. Glory to God. Making melody in your heart to the Lord. Verse 20 goes back to, as I said, being grateful. It says, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And then verse 21. And if you're walking by the Spirit, you're able to do this last verse. Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Glory to God. Amen for the reading and the hearing and the doing of his word. Hallelujah. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for bringing these verses alive to us. And I thank you that it brings clarity to the hearers and the readers of these words, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm going to focus on Awake Thou That Sleepest. The word sleepest, the Greek word is kathudo. Kathudo. And it means to fall asleep, to drop off to sleep, okay? It also, spiritually, it means to have a carnal indifference to spiritual things, or having a condition of insensibility, which means you're not being sensitive to divine things. And when we're insensitive to divine things, it causes us to conform to the world. Oh, we need the Spirit of God, saints. We need the Spirit of God. We need to be operating, walking, living, and having our being in the Spirit of God, so that we don't conform to this world, that we're able to renew our minds. Glory to God. And the word dead, I want to focus on that word, because it says, awake thou that sleepest. So awake from this human indifference that you have to spiritual things. wake up to this condition of being in, not sensitive to divine things to the point that it causes you to conform to this world. It says, arise from the dead. That word dead is nekros. Nekros. And it's a Greek word because the New Testament is written in Greek. And it means, one of the meanings is spiritually dead. That's one. Or it refers to being destitute or without power. It also means being inactive, inoperative. And in the Vines Dictionary, it speaks of the church being inactive and barren. Also, it speaks to the works of the law. Inasmuch as, however good in themselves, they cannot produce life. The works of the law cannot produce life. It is the spirit that gives life. The purpose of the law was to show us that we were in need of the Spirit of God to bring life where death was operating in us. In Vines, it also says that the faith that does not produce work, that's a type of death. Because this kind of faith is an intellectual faith. See, I can be aware of who God is. I may have confessed him as Lord and Savior, but it's all intellectual. I know the word of God. I can quote it. I've memorized it. I've memorized doctrines and systems. But they don't, because it's not life, it does not produce a work, which is a fruit of the Spirit. It doesn't cause me to walk in that faith and to produce in that faith, because it hasn't moved from a head knowledge down into my heart. Because out of the heart, the mouth speak. The heart will direct our actions. So whatever is in our hearts, glory to God, it will either bring life to us or it will defile us. Jesus says, not so much what we eat that defiles us as what is in our hearts. And if there are corrupt things in our hearts, it will surely defile us. Glory to God. So, you know, I feel that in this season where, as I said about the move of God, how the anointing, the increase of the anointing that is released right now in this season, we have to wake up and become alert to what God is doing. And if we are always naturally reacting to everything and not reacting in the spirit, we miss a lot of things. And as I was preparing this exhortation, there were a few things that I listed that we need to wake up to. The first one I put down that I listed was to wake up to the fullness of God's love for you. That is number one on the list. You have to know without a doubt how much He loves you. Romans chapter 5, I'm going to start in verse 8, and I'm going to read a few verses. It says, "But God showed His love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." He didn't wait for us to get our acts together. He didn't wait for us to turn around and say, "God, I need you. Come save me. Come rescue me." No, no, because we were dead. We were prisoners, held bound by this sin that had been passed on through the generations, beginning with Adam and Eve. So He had to come for us. He had to come and die for us. Verse 9 says, "Since therefore we have now been justified by His blood, much more shall we be saved by Him from the wrath of God." The wrath of God. We've been saved from the wrath of God. We who belong to the Lord, we who have accepted dying for us, His blood being shed for us, and receiving this truth into our hearts and confessing it with our mouths. We have been saved from the wrath of God. Glory to God. Verse 10. "For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of His Son." Enemies. Usually people in the world, when you have enemies, you're out to destroy your enemies. You really are. You're not trying to reconcile your enemies to yourself. See, this is a whole nother kingdom. This is a whole nother realm where enemies are being reconciled. And that's what we were, enemies of God. We were reconciled to God by the death of His Son. Much more, now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by His life? We need His life to walk in this salvation, to experience this power, this ever working power of salvation in our lives every day, all through the day. We have to be in the Spirit so that we are aware of His life working in us. His life is working in us. Hallelujah. It says that the first man, Adam, was of the earth, natural, but the last Adam was a life-giving spirit. A life-giving spirit. Glory to God. Verse 11 says, "More than that, we also rejoice." We rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. You know, that's a powerful word reconciliation. Glory to God. I am going to pull up this definition right quick. Reconciliation. Okay, first I gotta type it right. Okay, let's go for reconcile here. Glory to God. To restore to friendship or harmony. I am a friend of God. That's what that means. I was an enemy, but now I am a friend of God. I'm in harmony with God. I'm not warring against his spirit. That's why you have to stay in the spirit. Because what wars against the spirit? The flesh. The flesh wars against our very spirit. It also means that it's settled, it's resolved. Hallelujah. We thank God for that. We thank God for the restoration that we are friends. Jesus is our friend. That song goes, what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Hallelujah. And as a more contemporary songwriter, Israel, he says, I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. He calls me friend. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. So we want to wake up to the fullness of God's love for us. Because the more we are walking in his love and experiencing his love, it builds up our trust. It builds. It says faith worketh. The scripture tells us that faith worketh by love. So we need love. We need, and it's not, and it's talking not the Eros love, but which is this human passion kind of love, but the agape, this divine love. We need this divine love. It causes this faith to operate. So the more love that we have, that we receive from God, the more we receive from him, the greater our faith is. Because faith worketh by love. Glory to God. Glory to God. I'm going to take a moment and just worship him with this song. Glory to God. Glory to God. Oh Lord, I receive your love. Oh Lord, your tenderness melting all my bitterness. Oh Lord, I receive your love. Oh changing my unworthiness, oh Lord, I receive your love. Just stop and just breathe in this love. Oh Lord, receive your love. Oh Lord, I receive your love. God so loved the world. Oh Lord, I receive your love. Oh Lord, I receive your love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. The next thing we want to wake up to is the fullness of Jesus' finished work. On that cross, the last thing He, well, next to the last thing, He said, "It is finished." And then He said, "Father, I commend my spirit unto you." But it, He was saying that everything that I was sent to do by my Father, it has been done. And in John, the book of John, the Gospel of John, it says that if all that He had done could be written in books, the world, not the earth, but the world could not contain the volume. That's how great this finished work is. That is the need for the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will bring revelation to what we have captured in this book. But there are things to come that are not written of, that the Holy Spirit will speak of and is speaking of in the earth right now. But you must be walking by the Spirit. Glory to God. Clothe yourself in humility, knowing, recognizing that in and of yourself you can do nothing, that you need Him. He is your life. It says He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the way, the truth, the life. Outside of Him, there is no life. Outside of Him, there is no truth. Outside of Him, we are stumbling in the dark and have lost our way. So, part of this finished work, as I read in that Romans, out of Romans chapter 5, that we've been justified. It's finished. It's done. You're justified. You are justified by His blood. He who knew no sin was made sin. So that we could be redeemed. Because a judgment had to happen. Because God is a God of judgment. God isn't, He doesn't change. There's no variation in Him. There's no shadow of turning, the word tells us. So it cannot go unpunished. But Jesus, He took the sins of the world. He settled the sin issue by taking on the sins of the world, taking it to the cross, nailing it to the cross. Glory to God. So so that all who believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Everlasting life. It has, the life has no end. It's everlasting life. That's finished. The counting of our trespasses against us is finished. It's finished. He is not counting our trespasses against us. He has placed his spirit, the fullness of the Godhead, the kingdom of God lives on the inside of us. And because this glorious power is in us, sin shall not have dominion over us, for we are not under the law. Christ has fulfilled every dot, every tittle of the law. A law that we could not fulfill. He has come and he has fulfilled it. So the requirements have been fulfilled by Christ. Because of his finished work, the power of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit has been sent not to just live in us, but to rest on us, and to rest on us with an anointing. And this anointing is, it's a consecrating power. It sets us apart unto God, but it is also a power that gives us the ability to administrate the government, the things of the government of God in this earth. Through us, increase of his government and peace shall have no end. Because of this finished work, he has said that we shall do what he has done. The scriptures have shown us that he heals the sick, he casts out demons, and he preached the good news, setting the captives free. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. So these things we can do. And then he goes on to say even greater things. Even greater things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. Praise God. I'm going to take a moment right here. I don't know how far I'm going to get through this exhortation. Glory to God. It's just a move of the Spirit of God, and at some point I'll come back. I won't be able to come back to it next week because I have a special guest. Praise the Lord. Apostle Shirley will be with me, but I want to get through the things that we are awakening to, because we need to know these things in our hearts so that we are fully awake. Some of us are completely asleep. We got those who are actually of the called, but they haven't received God's calling yet, so they're still dead. So that's one form of sleeping. Then you've got those who are received the call, but they're not operating in it. So they're not operating in the power of God. That's another form of sleeping. Then you have those who are trying to fulfill it by performance, by what they do, which also leaves them in a place where there's an inconsistent expression of God's power in their lives. And that's another level of sleep. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. But I will be right back. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. God still will give you love. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Yes, he's faithful. So even when you turned your back on him, God is, you know, he's long-suffering. I mean, his mercy is, he's great. He's slow to anger. The Word of God says he's slow to anger, and yet he's rich in mercy. Praise God. Praise God. Okay, so I had just we got through waking up to the fullness of his finished work. All right. The first one was, of course, waking up to the fullness of God's love for you. That is foundational. That is foundational because if we are unsure of God's love for us, that is shaky ground. That's where the devil wants you, on shaky ground, where you're uncertain. So you've got to be rooted and grounded in the love of God. God is love. And then wake up to the fullness of his finished work, all that Christ has done. And as I said, it cannot be contained in books, all that he has done. So we have a portion written out for us. What? He has done. But praise God, he has given us the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, the Helper, the Paraclete, the one who's been called a son. He is the one that gives us the power to and enable us to walk in these things. He is the one that continuously reveals truth. He only doesn't speak of himself. He speaks what he hears from the very throne room of God. Hallelujah. Jesus, our high priest. He is our high priest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A high priest. You know, back in the Old Testament, the high priest went in once a year to sprinkle the blood of atonement over the mercy seat in the Holy of Holies, because only he, as the high priest, could go in. Once a year, and it had to be done continuously. And so even if you sinned after this was done, you just had to wait till next year. But praise God, we got a high priest, glory to God, who sits in the heavens continuously doing intercession for us. Let me read this. Hebrews, let's see. I want to go to Hebrews chapter, it's chapter 7. Okay. So we're going to follow me over to Hebrews chapter 7. Okay. I'm almost there. And we're going to drop down to verse 25. Consequently, he is able, talking about Christ, to save to the uttermost those who draw near to God through him. He's the only way. Since he always lives to make intercession for them. Thank you, Jesus. For it was, I'm going to read verse 26. For it was indeed fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy and innocent, unstained, separated from sinners, because the high priest in the Old Testament, they were men just like us. And sin dwelt in their flesh. And they were making a sin offering for themselves. And if when they went in, if their hearts weren't pure toward God, they could be struck down just being in the presence of God. But glory to God, we don't have to worry about being struck down by the being in the presence, going into the Holy of Holies because of our high priest, who was holy, innocent, unstained, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. He has no need, like those high priests, the ones I was just talking about, to offer sacrifices daily, first for his own sins and then for those of the people. Since he did this once for all, when he offered up himself. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Once. He went in once for your sin. He is not continuously dying and going in and making a sacrifice for the forgiveness of sins before the Father. It's been done once for all. This is what the Word of God is saying. He has no need, like those high priests, to offer sacrifices daily. He did this once for all when he offered up himself. Jesus, walk in the security of that. The accuser of the brethren is Satan. He wants to drive you into that place of condemnation. It's a place of weakness. It's a place where he can get at you. Because if you're in condemnation, then it gives him a foothold into your life to bring his dark work. Be secure once and for all. The next thing is to wake up to your true identity. It says, I'm not going to have time to read all the scriptures, but read them for yourself. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, read verses 17 through 19. It talks about us being a new creation. We've been born again, not of flesh and blood, but of this life-giving spirit. We've been made kings and priests. Read Revelations 5:10. 1 Peter 2:9 speaks of the fact that we are a chosen generation. This generation that came after the cross is a chosen generation. We're chosen. We're a royal priesthood. 2 Corinthians 5, and verse 20, it says we're more than conquerors, that we're ambassadors. We represent him. We represent him in the earth. For as he is, this is what 1 John says in chapter 4, verse 17. He says, as he is, so are we in this world. That's our identity. We're joint heirs with him. We have authority and we have power. Sin shall not have dominion over us. The old man died with him on that cross. Thank you, Jesus. We got to wake up and receive and walk in your inheritance. Wake up and receive and walk in your inheritance. You're sons of God, joint heirs with Christ Jesus. Everything that he has as a joint heir, it means a joint heir. You have exactly what he has. Does he have divine health? Yes, he does. Well, that's your inheritance. Does he have abundant life? Is there lack in him in any way? No. There's no lack in you. There's no lack in your life. Glory to God. Is there death in him? No, there's only life in him. As he is, so are you. You have access to the Father. Freely, freely. Every good and perfect gift comes down from our Father. We have become a, what's the word I want to use? An offspring. We're the offspring of Christ. He was the first fruit of them that slept. Death came in by one man, that first Adam. And then the resurrection of the dead came in through the final, the last Adam. For as in Adam all died, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. All who receive him shall be made alive. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. We praise your name. And so wake up to your inheritance. Wake up to your inheritance. So we want to wake up to the fullness of God's love for us. We want to wake up to the fullness of this finished work, all that has been done. We want to wake up to our true identity and walk in it, and we want to wake up and receive our inheritance and walk in this inheritance that we have. Continue to study the scriptures and see all these wonderful, wonderful things that the Lord has done. It's done. It's already done. It's a finished work. We are walking in a finished work. The work has already been done. We can rest because of that. Our faith, our walk is a walk of faith. And faith worketh by love, God's love. You got to know he loves you. Glory to God. So I need to stop right now. Hallelujah. And I want to remind you that tomorrow night, Friday Night Joy at 7 p.m. with Reverend Ray and friends, his featured guest is Sister Lakeisha Williams. the founder of Born Overcomers, Inc. And that, I am telling you, it is going to be an exciting broadcast, and I am looking forward to it. Glory to God. And then next Thursday, I'll be back, but I'll be back with my guest, Apostle and Shirley Jones. She's the pastor also of Rehoboth Family Life Center in Upper Marlboro. And I'm going to put her message. The last time that she was on was at the top of the year, and she gave us a prophetic message for the coming year, and she exhorted and taught and preached, glory to God, hallelujah, this word. So I'm going to put that out on Facebook so that you can listen to it before Thursday. Also on Sunday, we've got We've got Stronger Together with Sister Valerie Miller and her co-host, Reverend Ray. And that's every Sunday at 7 p.m. And then we have every Tuesday, his Abounding Grace Show with Minister Van. That's Tuesdays at 7 p.m. And then every fourth Saturday, the fourth Saturday of this month is the 28th. Our prophet Carla is coming back that 28th at 7 p.m. And she has a special guest coming on. So you want to make sure we'll be posting information about that upcoming show as well. Also, I want to remind you to go out to our website. Check it out, because we're always posting new information out there. There are a lot of things that are going on. There's also a link that you can click on to download your app. There's a Google Play Store link out there, and I believe there's a link for the Apple App Store, but if not, you know, you can just do it straight from your phones. But download the When Christians Speak app for your Android devices and for your Apple devices. Glory to God. Also on our website, there is a link. You'll see if you look at the top where all the little sections are titled, you'll see a title that says Coffee House Bookstore. If you click on that, it'll take you to that page. And you'll see that we've entered into a program with Amazon, and it allows you to order these K-cup coffees that are so popular now, Christian books, and quite a bit of good Christian books that are out there, you know, all types of Christian books. So, you know, if you read, fictional stories, which I sometimes read, you know, because I love movies and things like that. So, you know, good, solid stories and just Christian books exhorting the word of God and giving testimony, glory to God, are out there. And then we've got Christian music. So there's a nice range of Christian music out there as well. And so if you order through us, a portion of the sales will go toward defraying our administrative and production costs. And as I said, Reverend Ray has been digging deep down in his pockets, and it just, you know, it's just been a labor of love for him and for myself, you know, as we just want to be that voice that's crying out in the wilderness in these days with all that is going on, to prepare ye the way of the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. So also I want to remind you of our Facebook pages. We got the When Christians Speak Talk radio page, and then we have Christians Against Suicide and Depression page, which is to exhort and encourage those who are struggling with suicidal thoughts and thoughts of depression. And we know where that comes from, because it doesn't come from God. Glory to God. And even if it's a physical affliction that's causing the depression, it is not of God. Jesus is a healer. He brings divine health and life. And so in the meantime, as you struggle to get to that place of faith, there are resources out there for you, and there's information out there and support out there for you. And we pray for those who are struggling with that. Glory to God. Also, if you have any upcoming ministry events in this Washington, D.C. metropolitan area, reach out to us. Let us know. Contact us at on our website, or you can email us at Reverend Ray, and that's one word, and it's abbreviated R-E-V as in Victor, R-A-Y, Reverend Ray at whenchristianspeak.com, or you can email me, Reverend Pat, same thing, abbreviated, one word, Reverend Pat at whenchristianspeak.com. We would love to put you out on there. Oh, my time is running out. Also, we love featuring artists, Christian artists, whatever type, music, writers, spoken word, poetry. You can also contact us also. And also, I just want to remind you that podcasts are always available on iTunes and Zoom. You can also go to iHeartRadio, Spreaker.com, and Live 365. So I am signing off for today. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I praise God. I praise God for his word. I praise God for his goodness. Amen. 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 So I will see you next week, same time, with my guest. Glory to God.